If we hit play on a video, what happens? Exactly what we'd expect. It starts with the first frame, plays all the frames in order, same old story. But we'll link this example up a little differently. We'll tie this video, this sequence of images, to the scroll position on a page. And we'll do it like this. We'll set up our image sequence, we'll configure it in After Effects, we'll export using the body movement extension, we'll import it into Webflow and set up the layout, we'll set up a scroll-based trigger, and we'll link that trigger to the image sequence. Sounds like a lot, but we'll move fairly quickly and cover each and every step involved. So, the first part. Our goal is to have an image sequence, one image per frame in order. For this example, we'll start with a single video we want to import. This video was exported from, it was rendered in Cinema 4D. But for this to work as an image sequence, we have to first make it an image sequence. So we'll fire up Adobe Media Encoder. And you can drag most common video types right into the queue here. And there are two things we're looking for. Well, three if you care about where the images end up. The first is the format. We want the format to be JPEG. Now, can you do an image sequence using PNG files? Maybe you want transparency support? You can. But in this case, we're using a JPEG sequence. The preset we said we cared about before, there's only one preset in the dropdown. But if you're looking to make specific changes, you can click on the preset name and access more advanced options. Finally, we want to make sure the output destination and file name is set. When we're ready to start our queue, we'll press the tiny play button. And just like that, our single video file has been turned into an image sequence. If we open that up, we have the file name we chose, and appended to each JPEG is the frame number. This is our image sequence. That's the first part. The second part is putting this in After Effects. Let's drag our entire image sequence into our project bin. Traditionally, we'd create a new composition. But without doing that, let's drag all our selected images right into the layers area and let go of the mouse. And this is the important part, in addition to all the other important parts. We want a single composition. Since the dimensions on each image are the same, we'll leave the next part as is, but we want to make sure each still lasts one frame. Each image, each still is valued at one frame. And finally, we want to sequence our layers. We want them loading in order without any overlap, no overlap. When we hit OK, our image sequence is loaded right in After Effects into its own composition. Each layer, each frame represents one image in our image sequence. That's step two. Step three, let's export this using body movement. Window, extensions, body movement. Let's make sure this composition is selected for render. And this is really important. We want to go into our settings and take a look under assets. Two things here. We want to enable compression. How much compression? You can test this out to see what looks right, but our goal is to keep the file size down while maintaining good quality. So for this, let's try it out at 60. And the second thing here, let's include the images inside the JSON, the file we're going to export. Save changes. Let's set our destination folder where we want to export the JSON file. And once we've gotten everything configured, let's render. Now, this part can take some time, so we reached out to the creators of Jeopardy to see if we can use their theme song while we wait for the render to finish. We have yet to hear back. Once the render is finished, let's import our file into Webflow. From the Assets panel, we'll upload our file. We're just selecting the JSON we exported from After Effects. And once that's been brought in, we can drop it right onto the canvas. And just like any other HTML element on the planet, we can set dimensions. Let's set a width constraint here. We can simply type in a width and hit enter. That's step four. For the last two, we're going to use interactions. To set a trigger, let's go over to our interactions and add a page trigger. We want the animation to be triggered as we're scrolling through the page, so we'll select that option. That's step five. For the last part, let's bring it to life. On scroll, we want to play a scroll animation. We're creating a new animation here. At 0% scroll, when we're at the top of the page, we want our Lottie animation to be at the beginning. We're simply selecting the Lottie animation and adding an action, a keyframe, at 0%. And at 100%, when we're at the bottom of the page, we want the animation to be at the end. Now, image sequences can be a bit tricky since they're located at exact frames. So you might have to adjust. You can play around with the value here until it's just right. Now, If we're done with that, we can go to preview mode, we can try and scroll, and nothing. Why is that? No idea, except here's why. In order for the animation to animate as the page scrolls, the page needs to be able to scroll. Right now, there's nothing else on the page, so there's no ability to scroll. So let's go out of preview mode and set a height on the body element of 200 VH. This means 200% of the viewport height. If we do that and we preview, now we can start to see something happening. Our animation is animating based on our scroll position. Let's leave preview mode because we should figure this out. What if we set our animation to fixed? What if we set the Lottie animation's position to a fixed position? If we do that and we go back to preview mode, we can see the Lottie animation animates based on scroll and it stays fixed in the viewport exactly where we told it to go. Now, the animation behaves just like any other HTML element. So we've included an example project that uses this rows animation inside the context of a real layout. So check that out on Webflow University if you haven't already. But that's it. We prepped our image sequence, imported and configured it in After Effects, exported the JSON, wrote to the producers of Jeopardy, brought the JSON into Webflow, set up a trigger, set up the animation, and summarized everything we learned right before Gremer cut to black, before this sentence even finished.